Well, I'll give you one of my cards now. Best thing to do is always just to keep an eye on it and then you call me. Hi there. Yeah, I see him. He's a small one. I'm not going to be able to pick him up by the tail, so I'll just use my phone.
Hey guys, Willem from Blauberg Snake Rescue here. I've been away on holiday for a couple of weeks, but I'm back and I just collected this Cape Cobra from someone's house in Milnerton. They found it out in their garden, kept an eye on it, called me, stayed a safe distance of 5 meters away, and then I was able to capture it for them quickly. He was quite stressed out, so I'm going to see if I'm able to take a couple of photos of him before I let him go and just talk to you about him. You can see the head poking out there. I think he's still a little bit stressed. It's a sub-adult, so it's not fully full adult size yet. There we go. You can see him making a beautiful hood. That's, of course, the easiest way to recognize a Cape Cobra. If you see a snake making a hood in the Cape Town area, chances are very good that it's Cape Cobra. What you'll also notice if the hood goes down a little bit is they've got quite big cheeks on them. It looks like cheeks, but you can only really see it when the hood is down. That's where the venom glands are. And if you're bitten by a Cape Cobra, you need to get to a hospital as quickly as possible. They're very dangerous snakes. They've got neurotoxic venom, which means the venom causes your respiratory system to stop working. You're going to stop breathing. You can see he's still a little bit defensive. Let me just see if I can take a couple of photos, and then I'm going to let him go. So they've got neurotoxic venom, which means you stop breathing if they bite you. You don't really want that to happen, so don't try and get close to these guys. You can see in a case like this, he's only really striking at me because he's defensive and he's scared. If you leave a snake alone, it will always try and find a spot to go and hide and will try and get away. Best thing if you see one is just keep your eye on it, stay a safe distance away, give me a call and I'll come and capture it for you. Let's try and get it out. It's very anxious, so it's difficult to get them out when they're like this. I'm just going to try and pick it up very carefully. See how it's trying to hide under the newspaper the whole time. That's what snakes do. They don't chase people. They don't want to attack people. They want to get away from people. We're a danger to them, and they know that. Okay, relax. Relax. So my snake rescue service is completely free. If you find a snake in your garden, in your house, day or night, give me a call. I'll come and capture it for you. I'll move it somewhere safe, and you won't have to worry about it. Okay, so it's not really keen to move off. Just gonna give it its space. It's still on the defensive, so I'm just gonna take my stuff and move away. And notice how even with a defensive snake like this, it's not doing anything to me. It's not chasing me. In fact, it's kind of hiding there behind the bushes. It doesn't know what I'm gonna do. So it's trying to be careful, and as I move off, it's going to go away as well. Even though my service is free, we really appreciate any donations you can send our way to cover our fuel costs and so on. We've already got some awesome sponsors on board, like Reload Espresso Bar and Parkland, Sunningdale and Tableview. You can take a look at the comments on this video to find out how you can help us out as well. It's horrible, all this junk lying around here, hey? It's so unfortunate. Most of the natural spaces I go into to release the snakes, you find rubbish like this, even out in the middle of a bush where you wouldn't expect to ever see it. Please don't leave stuff like this lying around, guys. Anyway, stay safe.